Hello, Jenny Hall here for Trinity Stamps. Today I'm creating a Father's Day card with one of my children in mind who really has a strong fascination for lawnmowers. I'm going to be stamping with shoe sprites, stamps and dies, and use a sentiment from a Sentiment for Almost Everything stamp set. I'm also going to be using a couple of the stitched rectangle dies from the 4-bar card set. And I'm also going to be using the layered park tree stencil. I'll start out the project by having a piece of 80-pound cardstock in the Mini Misty, and I'm going to ink the images with enough space between them all so that I can place the metal dies and get all my die cutting done in one whack. I've used the Ink on 3's Blackout ink pad because it's a hybrid ink and it's really good for either watercolor or for alcohol markers. And it seems to be the one that I go to almost all the time now. It's a great ink. I'm going to color the images in with very simple coloring. I'm going to keep the little gnome red and blue. I am only going to be using 2 markers for most of this blending, and it's just enough because the image is small enough for me to add the darker color into the corner or shadow areas and then use that lighter color to mix with the darker where they overlap and bring it out to the other areas. For the face, I'm just using 2 light markers. I put one color in the center of the face and the other color on the outside, and it's enough to give me a natural looking flesh tone. And I'm doing the same thing for the hair and the beard, using a gray and a brown just to mix them together. My oldest son has a complete fascination with lawnmowers, and it's not rational, but that's okay. He has special needs, and lawnmowers are something that make him happy. So making a Father's Day card for him to give his dad with a little guy pushing a lawnmower is just perfectly right up his alley. So I'm going to create a background for these images, and there are 2 stitched rectangles in the 4-bar card die set. I'm using the larger of the 2 to make a layer for the panel, and I'm using the smaller of the 2 for the actual panel. I did make the die cut before I added any ink blending because it tends lately that I'm getting my die cutting plates all inky and yucky because I am not waiting for my ink blending to dry. And so this was my prevention method for not getting my plates all yucky. Now, when I saw that this tree stencil, which is very, very pretty, had these leaf images where you can create your own tree, it made me think of patches of grass. And so I just added this onto what was already a very large section of green for the grass. And check it out. It looks like texture that could be grass. It's not meant to be grass, but as many of our crafting products usually evolve into another purpose, this worked out that way. Now here's how I create with the top portion of the grass. There is a scenic border die that has a grass die, and I grab the top half of the die cut and secure it down to do ink blending underneath area. And then I do the opposite, whatever I want to add the sky. And it matches up perfectly because I just move the die cut left or right until it lays over in exactly the same place as the other one did. You could add a little pixie spray to this if necessary, but I don't have any trouble when I just hold it down, and I used a little bit of post-it tape here on the sides to make sure that it helped me to keep the pieces in place. And this method works out every single time. Now, there has been a few times when I've grabbed the wrong die cut, but I very quickly, you know, identify that I made a mistake and I grab the right one. But this is just the easiest way for me to make the look of grass. The grass was colored with green and yellow, and so that gives it kind of more of a lively look to me. Now, here is that little Happy Father's Day stamp image from the stamp set that's called A Sentiment for Almost Everything. And I had to leave this part in the video. This is the stamp cleaner that I'm using that's available in the Trinity store. And it is from Ink On 3. And you gotta know that it's the best stamp cleaner I've ever used. I'm using it all the time. You gotta check it out. I'm adhering that panel unit with some double-sided foam tape. And now I'm putting all of the little cute images together with more double-sided foam tape. The hardest part here is deciding where I'm going to put everything. The only thing I knew for sure in my mind is I wanted the gnome to be pushing the lawnmower, but I wasn't sure where I was going to put all the grass. So I decided on putting the small patch of grass in front of the lawnmower, because that would look natural, that it needed to be cut. And then another patch of grass, which was larger and contained a flower that could also double as a weed. We have lots of dandelions growing in our yard, and my son that likes to do the lawnmower will just run right over them. I'm going to add the clouds up in the top and then secure the handle of the lawnmower with a little dab of glue as well. Now, here's something new that I haven't shown you before, and this is the little tidy tray from Trinity Stamps, and it's a little tray that you can dump your sequins or rhinestones or clay bits in, and then shake it around to make sure you get the right side of it to adhere down to your project. And use your Marvy jewel picker, or whatever your choice is, and just adhere them so easily down to the project. I've been using this little tidy tray for a while, but it's now available in Trinity's store, and I can tell you that it is amazing. I like the fact that I can let all of the pieces out of the box to see what size I want, and then I can just funnel them right back in that little box. It works like a charm. Thank you all so much for spending time with us today at Trinity, and we would love to interact with you on social media.